tiny break to 50 Shades of Cray Cray.
How can anyone go somewhere new and be expected to enjoy themselves without at least a decade to decompress?
No idea when to go, how to eat, or what to do.
It's impossible to stop the whole thing from turning into a monumental fudger.
But let not tears spoil your cheeks. I, Nikki Chauvin-Struce, am about to apply a cold cup of tea to your bleeding breath.
Accompanied by my idiot boyfriend.
It's like a Scotch egg, but filled with coleslaw and long.
I'm going to take you hurtling through a maxi mini break.
Who mind out, you're getting in someone's way.
This is travel without mercy.
God, rain drop right in my eye.
We're here, but should we have come?
This is called what I can't pack in my bag chic.
Because I can't get my fur coat to fit in my bag.
So again.
Do you like it since I've started just wearing band t-shirts instead of being smart like I used to be?
I don't like it when you don't answer the question that I just asked you. I said, where are we going?
I've got that disease where you can't understand what people are asking you.
Another part of the brain related to speech is Wernicke's area, which is associated with language comprehension. Patients who damage this region can speak fluently, but are unable to understand language or use it in a meaningful way.
Go to Copenhagen.
Yay!
Gateway to the West. Stop here.
No. Come to train.
Ivor the engine. There he is, trundling along the loop line above the quarry.
Holiday!
Speedy boarding.
Speedy boarding event.
Surely you want to go and sit on the plane for longer than everybody else.
Speedy wanker. Look at me. I'm speedy boarding. I'm going to walk really fast into a small metal box and spend longer in it than everybody else. Like a champion.
Winning at life.
I'm leaving on a jet plane, don't know when I'll be back again. Do you feel the power of the gladiators?
I'll go get you. Baggage belt. Baggage belt.
If we get the CPH underground to Helsingør, that will take us to middle of town, and it's 4 minutes walk.
Okay. Yeah. Drag back. Morning. We are in
Copenhagen.
We're in Copenhagen. We got up and got dressed. We got here. Why do you keep hiding behind me like a freak?
It's funny.
No, it's not funny. We got here at about 4 o'clock yesterday, is that right?
Yeah.
And then went and got some dinner last night, checked into the hotel, which we couldn't work out, should we cross over? And windy. Not too cold though.
That's alright, we were told it was going to be really cold.
Yeah, so it's alright. Today's plan, what are we doing?
We're off to the zoo first.
But before that, we're going to get a coffee.
Get a coffee somewhere. Hopefully have a bit of a shop around on the way to the zoo, see if there's anything good there. Apparently the Mikella Brewery bar.
You're obsessed with the Mikella Brewery.
Yeah. Because I've done Carlsberg and it's piss water, so.
Yeah, Carlsberg is disgusting.
We'll try Mikella instead, which is a lot more up our street, I think.
Yeah,
maybe not this early. Maybe later on.
So we'll be back next with some footage of some cool animals, if they're not all hiding, because it's windy and cold. Whoa! Natural disaster caught on tape.
It's the only hill in Denmark.
It's
to walk up it.
There it is.
It's no Park Street. I hope.
A lot of people won't get that reference. Of international viewers.
We used to live in Bristol, which is a city that's way too lumpy for its own good. And you have to walk up a lot of hills to get anywhere. Which is why we've got such strong legs and such pert buttocks these days. And this is a bit of a flashback. Because living in London now, we're far too posh to walk up anything to get a tube. Yeah, here we are. As a result of our inability to speak any foreign languages at all, having to walk up hills nonetheless.
I feel oppressed and depressed and out of breath. Almost made it to the summit though. There we go. Steep as anything. I think I can see my house from here.
It's a zoo at the top in lights. Yeah.
Here's one. Oh. Hello, Mises.
Look at his feet.
These all look like babies, actually. That looks like Mama over the back. Mm. Looks like a baby. Hello. And little stripy legs. What are you doing? Oh, she big, isn't she?
Got a primordial pouch there.
Yeah.
Welcome back. Snoop Doggy Dogg, Wu-Tang, Puff Daddy, all record-setting rap artists. And now there's Rebel XD. And what sets him apart from all the other rappers is speed.
I want to make it a rhyme, but I come to get him, I'm breaking him up, and it's becoming an enemy, telling incredible, they're competing me, open the cup, and you let me double the rhyme, and double the store, I hold him, I dial him, I tattle him, I make it a vital one, then I'm getting him another side, I'm hanging him up, but he's becoming a vital me, that'll be dumb in the fact, and kind of be stupid to step on the taking the weapon away from rap, I'm going to be dope, then I'm a capital pack, and a fact, and a grab, and a rap, and a choke. Stupid comedian rappers, I'm going to be lyrical, enemy, so I'm stepping up, and I'm better, I'm making it better, and then I'm stepping to get him, egging him up, when I'm making him up, when I'm taking him up, when I'm staking him out of my academy, getting him better, and better, and later, when he want to be stepping to me, when I hit him, kind of jamaica, rhyme on the floor, and drop him down, when I kick him, and rap, and be confounded, making us.
That's it, that's all you get in. Oh, stop. Not just chewing for you.
Get him, what am I hitting him, eat him, beat him, see him, taking him off when I come in the feed him and popping and dropping and coming him off and mopping again, and then I'm a shock, I'm making a prayer when I'm breaking it down with lyric and making a follow me.
I'm slightly concerned if that and that are in there.
The battle royale.
No, in the children's zoo.
Yeah. Children love that.
And look at the size of those meerkats. Oh, sorry, bunny. I didn't mean to scare you.
This bunny looks sick. Oh, there's some goats over there.
Oh.
Stood on things, looking ready to rumble.
Goat rumble. Smells like goats. Bunny. Yeah.
It's working.
Denied.
I didn't even flirt with an ostrich properly.
You're on his birthday last week. It's Marty's birthday tomorrow.
Oh, it is Marty's birthday tomorrow. We should find Marty and sing him happy birthday. I want to find Carl. But is that Carl? Who's that? Carl, is that you? Is it you, Carl? Tell me where Carl is.
Where's Carl?
Yeah, where's Carl?
He's in the office having a meeting with the rest of the minkies.
The minkies?
The minkies.
Is that Carl? Carl, is that you? Carl? Carl?
His ears perked up.
That is Carl. He's got very droopy nipples. Okay. Okay, we're out of here. We're out of here. I'm leaving.
You're in.
Droopy butt.
Oh, droopy butt. Oh, dear.
Dude, get off.
Frog fight.
In your face.
This one's coming to rescue, or? I can't believe how big that one is. Why are you two so rowdy? He is definitely the bully boy.
Day was dark and gray clouds filled the sky. In my heart there only was a sigh. You appeared and skies above were blue.
Into the cistern, is it called?
Cistern.
Cistern. And we've got to put on wellies to go into the art exhibition, which I think is the first time I've ever had to put on wellies to go into an art exhibition. So this might be fun. We've got to try and find our size first. There's the racks of wellies. Finding your size? Oh, okay. I'm a 39. Ooh. Shh. 39. There we are. That's the ones. Where do we leave our shoes?
There's some down there. I guess you put them up on the shelf.
Take them with you, maybe?
but...
Where we been, what we done?
Been to the Michele bar. The official bar of the Michele brewery. And it was okay. We had, seven or eight different types of beer?
Quite a lot of beers.
Yeah.
Some which is weird, why one of my eyes is going that way. And one is going that way.
Mm-hmm. More so than usual.
Yeah.
Oh, and now we're off to get some snacks from a supermarket. A supermarket challenge.
So, something I like to do when I'm abroad is play supermarket challenge. So, you go to the supermarket and you pick stuff that is in the language of the country.
He spotted the nacho cheese Doritos.
And then you see if it's edible.
Yeah, last time I ended up with a kind of German version of a picnic bar. It was like a Ginster's but long.
What's the picnic bar?
Picnic bar is a, it's like a Scotch egg but filled with coleslaw and long.
It's wrong in so many different ways.
But apparently it's a thing in Germany, so there you go.
Well, there you go. Time to go get some snacks. Oh yeah. Good morning. Day
hello.
Two? Three?
Day three.
Night two. Night two. What?
Yeah, so we just had night two.
Oh, okay. That makes sense. I thought that was the wrong way around for a moment.
I don't know what we're doing. I haven't had any coffee yet.
We haven't had any coffee. And also, we had about 25 beers last night. So, our voices are a register lower than usual.
Yes.
Yes. So today we are off to.
We're gonna try and do a boat trip.
Neil's in charge of planning. Going? Not going?
We're gonna try and do a boat trip. And we've got tickets for the Tivoli later on. So between those two, I don't know, we're probably gonna wander around, maybe try and see some of the nice gardens and maybe see a museum.
Yeah.
I don't know how much we can cram in because we're kind of slow moving today.
It's a very grey day as well. As you may be able to tell. You look good in front of that though.
Yeah, that's my communist roots showing.
It's alright, isn't it? It's not communism here though.
It looks quite communist though.
Yeah,
me
but
standing
it's not.
In front of a large building background.
It's your blonde hair and your blue eyes maybe.
Yes.
We need coffee, so we're going to do that now. Okay, see you at the harbour.
Darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again.
Why does he look like Chad Kroger?
Look at this graph!
Oh, buddy. Temper. What are you doing?
Having some breakfast outside a nice cafe in the rain, which is much more high quality Scandinavian rain than you get in England.
It's very pure.
Yeah, we're definitely not having a worse time than we would have had if we'd stayed there.
At least the rain hasn't got a slight tinge of bins to it. Spicy sausage?
Strangely sweet sausage.
Ooh.
Which is my nickname at school.
I think this must be the library that we're sat next to, which is very pretty and very Hogwarts. And then in the cafe that we're next to, it's also a bookshop. So it's but unfortunately it is ram in there, so we can't get a table. So instead we're sharing a breakfast outside in the sludge.
Mickey's very serious about this. Up the round tower, much like the cathedral in Seville, they went for ramps instead of stairs. Ramps seem a lot easier to walk up than stairs. So hopefully this tower trip should be a lot less strenuous than the old legs.
And it smells weirdly like pastrami in here for some reason.
Like pastrami?
Yeah, it smells like pastrami, do you not think? Pastrami.
So here we are at the end of the journey.
I promised there was no stairs. What the hell is this sheet? Yeah. Why is there stairs?
They run out of slope. There's only eight.
Sounds like there might be more than eight.
There's one way to find out.
Have traditional coffee and then you can have coffee that's served in a wine glass. But it's very hot.
Yeah.
That's it's having on thin ice, putting it in a wine glass, and it's very thin and it's hot.
Yeah. I see you like to live dangerously.
Yeah.
I also like to live dangerously. It feels weird being in the Botanical Garden when it's dark.
That's because it's been dark all day.
Quite relaxing. To be in the air would be nice.
Yeah. I understand why they have a cafe that's like, could be about five times the size of it is.
Who knows why the Danes do anything?
I don't know, because there's no instructions on anything and nobody tells you how to do stuff.
Yeah, maybe people in this country are idiots and don't need to be told how to do things. But we are.
To be told I'm an idiot.
We're being discriminated against
exactly.
Just because we're idiots.
Exactly.
It feels unfair.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you think?
Really good.
Yeah. Traditional, tasty, little crunchy bits. Yeah.
Morning, day three in Copenhagen. No, day four. Day three? I don't know. Some days, the last day in Copenhagen. So we are going home today. We're just checking out of the hotel now. I'm going to put our stuff in a locker. We've got a little bit of time before our flight, so we're going to go off and do a little bit more exploring and then make our way home. Last night we went to Tivoli, which was really good fun, which is like a theme park here. And it's kind of like a bit like Thorpe Park or like kind of a cheaper looking Disney. But it was really good. Unfortunately, quite a lot of the rides were not working because of the rain, so we only got to go on a couple of rides, but they were really good fun. And the food was amazing there. They've got amazing like gourmet food hall. So we went and enjoyed that, so that was good. And Neil's just getting us a coffee now and some change. We're gonna put our bags in the locker and then head off to the harbour. We didn't end up making it to the, well, we kind of did make it to the harbour yesterday, but we sort of ran out of steam by the time we were kind of getting there. It was a bit of a longer trek than we thought it would be, so we didn't end up actually going to the harbour. Here comes Neil with the coffee and the cake. Yay! I think I'm going to have to go because he's run off.
Can I help you?
Welcome to my episode of Cribs. Like laugh at peasants. Sometimes I don't even because I'm nice like that.
Pays the bills.
Welcome to the old drinking cupboard. This is a family home. Larry, Barry, Gary. And oh, there's Harry.
Beautiful Harry.
Yeah.
Just editing this now, and what the hell is that noise in the background? It definitely wasn't Neil. Did we catch some kind of ghostly cough? It's really weird. Anyway, back to the video.
Berinda was her real name.
Last time children were allowed in here. And
had them hollowed out and stuffed.
Genuine heads.
Beautiful. So lifelike.
Well, they are lifelike because they're real.
Ah. Yeah.
This clip just makes me laugh so much. Look at that lady's face that's waiting for her baggage, and she cannot work out what is coming along on the baggage carousel. But it's just our little camera that's on the carousel. But yeah, her face cracks me up.
Are we home?
Hi.
So we're home, as evidenced by the fact that Boots is now very, very close.
What were your favourite things about Copenhagen?
I liked...
Big butts?
I cannot lie. I liked the leopard, baby leopards zoo and the underground art exhibit in the cisterns. The little cafe that we went to and got food was very nice. How about you?
No bites. Did you catch that brutality then?
No remorse.
My favourite bits about Copenhagen are like the art gallery, splashing about with the wellies on. I like the Botanical Gardens.
Yeah, that was very stylish, wasn't it?
That was quite good. I feel like the botanical bit could have been bigger, but I don't think
there's much you can do about that. I don't know why they turned the rest of it into an art gallery unless it was something I was missing. I really like Tivoli.
It's proper Christmassy.
Silly and very Christmassy, which is nice. I like drinking all the beers in the Mikkeller bar. Mikkeller or Mikkeller?
Either way, I'm not going to hold it against you.
Okay.
Would you go again?
It's not an instant yes. I think I'd probably go again, like, if I couldn't think of anywhere else to go.
There you go, resounding qualifier for the tourist board of Copenhagen there.
I don't know whether we just didn't find the coolest bits or whether it's like kind of down season, but it was very quiet, wasn't it? There wasn't much going on.
Yeah, that wasn't all that bad, the fact that it was quiet.
Would you go again?
I think my answer is the same as yours. I don't know whether it was just that it was a bit gloomy and whether that was... My mum said it was like that over here as well this weekend, but it seemed especially gloomy.
Yeah.
And I think whenever you see it on the telly or in pictures, it always looks really bright and crisp, but it wasn't really bright and crisp.
No, it was a bit drizzly.
So it wasn't being shown off to its best.
No.
Yeah, I think we found some good bits. And found them quicker than when we went to Berlin, for instance.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's going to have to go something to kick Prague off my favourites list.
Yeah. And on that note, thank you for joining us for this video. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. If you want to see more videos like this, just let me know in the comments down below. Suggest where we should go next time as well. Well, I'll ruin it for you now. Spoiler alert, we're off to Budapest in January, so we will film that. Then, anything you want to add?
Nope. Back to work tomorrow.
Boo.
Yeah.
You want to show everybody your T-shirt?
What a Debbie Downer it was, but I'm fully repping the Macabre London merch, now available direct from Nikki Drews.
From the Etsy shop.
Yeah.
The link is in the description below.
Yeah, we can provide a bag of cat hair.
Yeah.
If you want to style it like mine.
Yeah, that's very true. Anything else?
No, that's all you need from me.
Okay, that's all you need from me. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye. Have a brew.
Probably a good idea.